Hello everyone, Amud here from the Target Common YouTube channel, and I'm here with another topic on this episode. So it has been a long delay actually in the next video because of some personal emergencies, but yeah, I will try to be continuing posting other videos as well. Okay, so in this particular video we are going to learn to write JSON path, or how can we extract the values from JSON arrays. So earlier we have already covered how to write the JSON path for simple JSON objects and nested JSON objects, okay. And also we know already what is JSON object and what is JSON array. Even we have covered simple and nested both, okay. So we know that JSON path is important to fetch the values from JSON, right? So in this video we are going to learn to write the JSON path for JSON arrays. Earlier we have seen for the JSON objects, okay. So let me go to IntelliJ, Eclipse, and in this project, existing project, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create another class, okay. And to create it, new, and a new class called JSON path for JSON array, okay. So what I'll do, I'll put simple, okay. So and let me open JSON editor online as well, okay, so that we can create a JSON and we can use that one. So we'll learn to create programmatically these JSONs, okay, in upcoming videos, but we don't know as of now, so we are going to use the same thing. So earlier we have already seen that this is also a proper JSON array, correct? So let me add more values. So suppose when you hit in API, okay, you get this type of response. Okay, let me add a main method. Not sure what Eclipse is hanging today, but let me maximize it. Okay, so if you see this particular JSON, this is also a valid JSON array, right? So let me see how can we fetch the values from here. Okay, so let me store this particular JSON array in a variable called JSON array itself. Okay, so I have stored, and we know that we have a JSON path class, okay, for which we need to create an object, and remember this JSON path is coming from the accessor package itself. Okay, new JSON path. Okay, and what we need to do, we need to pass the JSON array here as an argument to the constructor, right? I'm passing JSON array. Okay, so we had done, right, similar kind of things we have done for JSON objects. This time we are doing similar kind of thing for JSON array, but here we need to have some different mechanism. Okay, so simple, suppose this is a normal Java array, and suppose if I say you that, okay, if I want to fetch the 30 here, right, so we need to know at which index it is, right? So this array generally is normal Java array only, and here we have total 5 elements, and the index of array starts from 0. So at 0th position we have 10, at the first position we have 20, similarly at second index we have 30, because index is starting from 0, so 0 1 2 3 4. And if I want to get the length of this array, so we can easily get similar pattern we need to apply for JSON path as well. Okay, so what I need to do simple JSON path. Okay, see, just remember this JSON path is the object which I'm referring here. Okay, JSON path dot get. Okay, dot get, what you do to simply in double quotes, okay, pass the index, which index, 0 or whatever index you want. And if I print this one, shift out, it will give you 10. Okay, So what is the problem? Okay, so let me use get string. Okay, so that there will be no issues, right? If I run it, why string? Because this particular array has 10, right? This 10 is string here because I am putting in double quotes. Okay, so let me run it and I will see that I will get the output as 10. Okay, so actually, see, we can see. So already we know that everything in JSON path starts from dollar sign, right? So dollar of zero actually. So it should be ideally like this, dollar of zero. Okay, but we know that in this recessive JSON path, they don't need to write dollar sign, right? So what we need to do, similarly, whatever we've done for JSON object, simply remove the dollar sign and write remaining. Okay, so if I want to get the last index, right? So let me put 4. So what it will do, it will give me 50. Okay, it will give 50. Now you might ask, okay, what will happen if I am passing some index which is not existing? Okay, which does not exist means maybe because the size of this particular JSON array is only 5. And suppose if I, so I can pass till 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose if I pass 5, what should happen now, right? Let me run and show you what happens. Okay, what you got? Null. Why null? Because when we're fetching a get string, right? Get string. So that null is the valid value for string. That's what we're getting here. Okay, but that depends which data type we are getting fetching for. Okay, so okay, so now you might ask, okay, if I want to know the size of this JSON array, how many elements are in this JSON array? Very simple. What we need to do? Sys out JSON path, okay, dot get list. Okay, we have one method called list, get list. So why get list? You can simply, as of now, you can understand because 10 was a string value, right? So we use the get string. If we have boolean, then we'll use get boolean, which we have already seen in previous example. Similarly, here, this particular thing can be represented as a list, right? This is a list in Java. Okay, so that when I will explain to you that how can we create this type of JSON array through programs, that time I'll explain that why list and all. But as of now, you can understand this particular JSON array can be represented as list, right? So what I did, get list, and what I'll do, I will pass dollar sign. Okay, so in previous examples where we have written the JSON path for JSON objects, when you write this particular dollar sign, so it gives me the whole JSON context, right? So same thing will happen here. Okay, but this time it will give me the context as a list. Okay, because this 10, 20 are in a list, right? Then we can directly call the methods called size. Okay. So in this one, I will get the size of particular JSON array, right? 5. We're getting the size. So this question, this particular program is important because sometimes these questions are asked in the objective questions as well as in programs also, in the interviews also, because many people will confuse you because they will be seeing this type of JSON array. Okay, like this type of JSON array. Okay. So, but they are not facing this type of JSON array, so they are getting confused with this. Okay, how can we write this JSON array? That is very simple. That is nothing. That is simple JSON array, and you need to just use the index concept. Okay. Now let me make it little more complex. Okay, we can have nested JSON array, means JSON array inside JSON array. What I'll do for simple learning purpose, what I'll do, I will put the entire content inside another JSON array. Okay, you can see you can see we have one JSON array that is inside another JSON array. Okay, so in this case, what will happen? How can we write the JSON path? Okay, so what I will do, let me create a copy of this particular class. Okay, and let me go to second class. Here, what you need to do, let me copy paste the entire thing here. And let me paste it here. Okay. So this is nothing but this is again your kind of two-dimensional array. Okay. So what I need to do, simple thing, learn to understand here. Earlier we had only this much, right? So we use the data index concept. When you are at here, right? So you can see, okay, we have another JSON array inside this. Okay, or suppose if we have multiple, okay, let me put 200, 200, 300, 400, 500. Okay, when we had only this much, right, so we can understand, okay, 10 is the 0th index, 20 at the first index, and so on, right? When you are here, top, you can see, okay, at 0th index, we have this much. Okay. And the first index we have this much, okay, and this particular outer JSON array contains two elements. Okay, that is possible. So this is the way we need to understand. So let me copy this example only and paste it here. So suppose here what I want to do, I want to print this value. Okay, so what I need to do from here, you need to jump to the first index because this is the 0th index, okay, and this is the first index. So we need to jump here, okay. Then you can jump to whatever index inside we want, because we want 300, so we need to put 2 because that is third in position and second at index, okay. So what I need to do, simple, you need to use 1, so we'll get this much, okay. Inside this, we need to jump again, right? So you need to use immediate indexing again. Okay, remember this is the thing here. What we need to do first from here, jump here. Okay, so how can we jump? Using index, right? And again, this much only thing you have only this one. Now we know how to write the JSON path for this because we'll just learn now, right? Same thing to use another index immediately. So what is the meaning? The first index, after reaching to the first index, go to the third index. Okay, so since we need 2, right, because we want to face 300, so it will be 0, 1, 2, right? So let me run it. Okay, we can see it is fetching 300. So this is the way. This is very simple way. But in interview, they might ask you question on this, and you might get confused. The basic concept is same. You need to use index concept. Now, you may also want to know. Okay, I want to get the size of this particular JSON array. Okay, what is the size of this particular JSON array? Okay, so what you need to do? First thing, you need to jump to a particular specific index element, and then you need to face the size. Okay, but here you need to have some more lines of code. Okay, why? Because suppose if you do this one, get list of dollar dot size, so it will give this much, right? It will give you this much. Okay, when you're calling the size method, okay, because we are getting it as a list, so it will give this, the length will be 1 plus 1, so total it will be 2. Okay, so let me run for you, and you can see the size will be 2. Correct? But now question is different. I want to get the size of internal JSON array, right? Listed JSON array. I want to get the size of this or that, right? So how can we do that one? So for that, we need to write some lines of extra code. First thing, what you need to do, you need to use JSON path dot get list, right? why list? Because it contains a list only, right? Get list dollar. Okay, then we know that when you do the get list, it give me all the method coming from list interface, right? So I can use get again, right? Because we know how to use the array list, linked list, right? So we can use array list. We can use the index concept there. So similar thing, when you get the list, we can use the get method and call everything using the index. Okay, and when you get it from index, so what actually it will be? Okay, so it will be another list, right? List of only to put object only. Okay, internal list. Okay, so what actually I've done here? When I need to cast it as well. So what I done actually, when you are here, right? And when you do the get list, so we get everything. Okay. And we use the get of zero means we're getting this much, right? And this is again one list only, right? This is again one list only. So what I did, I casted it to list of object because this is my list only. If suppose when you have only this much, so this you can represent as a list of object. This should be ideally string, but I put the simple list of object. So that doesn't matter here. Okay. And we simply need to cast it. Then you need to call the size method on internal list. Okay. Internal size. Okay. So this time we'll get the size as 5. Okay, we are getting the size 5. Okay, similarly, if I want to get the size, if we get the size of this JSON array, so what you need to do? Just use get of 1, right? And it'll give you size as 6. Okay, so simply you need to navigate based on the index. There's nothing. And just need to cast it properly. And you know that when you don't know the type, you need to use get method. Then again, you need to cast it only properly. Otherwise, you will get the class has exception. Right? So here we are getting. Okay. So why is it returning you 5? Okay. I think I'm not updated here. That's why. So let me copy and let me paste it here again. Okay. So this time, second array has 6 elements. Okay, something I messed up here. So let me first delete it. Okay, then paste it. Okay. So you remember because someone is asking me like how to put the slash r and slash r. I am not putting anything. Just give the double quotes and paste inside it. Automatically it will be formatted. Okay. So now this time we'll get the size as 6. Okay, so this we have covered only for the simple JSON arrays, and this is tricky. That's why I'm covering it as a separate topic. And in the next video, I'm going to cover the JSON path for this type of JSON arrays. Okay, so stay tuned. Next video will be coming soon. Okay, thank you, everyone.